Hello everyone, myself Manpreet from a nursing school. So once again, most welcome to my channel. So this video is specifically for those who are going to appear for Baba Fried University of Health Sciences Staff Nurse exam. So this video include the very important golden points from subject medical surgical nursing and fundamentals of nursing. So please, if you are going to appear for this exam, so don't miss this video and please watch the video till the end. And please subscribe the channel if you have not subscribed yet, so that you can receive all upcoming notifications. So without wasting more time, let's begin. Okay, so let's begin with the endocrine system. And here is the first point. It is the Addison disease. Addison disease is a hyposecretion of the adrenal cortex hormones. Means there is a decreased secretion of glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids. So next is the clinical manifestation seen in Addison disease. So these are hypoglycemia, hyponatremia, hyperkalemia, hypercalcemia, and weight loss and hyperpigmentation of skin or postural hypotension. So this is about the Addison disease. Next is the Cushing syndrome. So Cushing syndrome is characterized by hypersecretion of the adrenal cortex hormones. So means there is an increased secretion of the glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids. And the sign and symptoms seen in Cushing syndrome are hyperglycemia and hypernatremia, hypokalemia and hypocalcemia, then truncal obesity with thin extremities, weight gain is seen in Cushing syndrome, then hypertension, moon face and Buffalo hump. So next is the myxedema coma. So it is a very serious and rare disorder and usually results from persistently low thyroid production. And the clinical findings seen in myxedema coma are hypotension, hyponatremia, then hypothermia, hypoglycemia and generalized edema. So these clinical findings associated with these diseases like Addison, Cushing, myxedema coma are very important from examination point of view. So do remember all these. So our next important point is the common cause of hyperthyroidism is Graves' disease. So remember this, the Graves' disease is associated with the hyperthyroidism. And in case of hypoparathyroidism, the positive Troisi and Chevostic signs are seen. So in hypoparathyroidism, hypocalcemia is there. So due to hypocalcemia, there are the positive Troisi and Chevostic sign. So in the Chevostic sign, there is a twitching of the facial muscles in response to tapping over the facial nerve area. And what is Troisi sign? It is a carpopedal spasm caused by inflation of the BP cuff. And this BP cuff is inflated to above the systolic pressure for 3 minutes. So this Chevostic and Troisi sign are seen in hypoparathyroidism. Why? Because there is a hypocalcemia. So in this condition, hypoparathyroidism, calcium gluconate and vitamin D are prescribed. And in case of hyperparathyroidism, in hyperparathyroidism there is a hypercalcemia. So due to this, the calcitonin is prescribed. So this increases the urinary elimination of the calcium. So with this, moving to our next point, the hyperglycemia is a common adverse reaction of the steroid therapy. So if the patient is put on corticosteroids, then there is an increased risk of the hyperglycemia. So with this, moving to our next important pointer, the anterior pituitary gland secretes growth hormone, TSH, which is thyroid stimulating hormone, ACTH, prolactin, then melanocyte stimulating hormone, then FSH and LH. And the hormones released by or secreted by posterior pituitary gland are ADH or vasopressin and oxytocin. So do remember all these points. These are very important for VF2HS staff nurses exam. So our next pointer is the Cullen sign and Turner signs are indicative of the pancreatitis. So what is Cullen sign? It is a discoloration of abdomen and periumbilical area. And Turner sign is a bluish discoloration of the flanks. And these both are seen in case of pancreatitis. Cullen sign and Turner sign. So with this, moving to the next important pointer. It is about Murphy sign. So Murphy sign is seen in case of cholecystitis. So what is this? So in this sign, the patient is unable to take the deep breath when when examiner fingers are passed below the hepatic margin. So patient is unable to take the deep breath because of pain. So our next important pointer is the hepatitis A transmitted via fecal oral route, mainly by contaminated water or contaminated food. So hepatitis B is transmitted by contaminated blood products or articles, then shared contaminated needles or infected saliva, or via sexual contact. Same like hepatitis B, hepatitis C is also transmitted through blood and blood products. And hepatitis B is also transmitted through blood and blood products and also through the close personal contacts. While hepatitis E is transmitted through fecal oral route. So hepatitis A and hepatitis E both are transmitted via fecal oral route, while hepatitis B, C and D are transmitted via infected blood or body fluids. So with this, moving to our next pointer, the severe diarrhea containing blood and mucus is seen in case of ulcerative colitis. So our next pointer is the most common type of brain tumor is the gliomas. So this question is already asked in BFGHS tutor exam. So our next important pointer is, in ischemic stroke, the thrombolytic therapy with recombinant tissue plasminogen activator should be started within 3 hours of onset of the ischemic stroke. Next pointer is, the Bell's palsy results from inflammation of 7th cranial nerve. And the 7th cranial nerve is also known as the facial nerve, and Bell's palsy is also known as the facial paralysis, and in this there is a paralysis of the one side of face. So next pointer is, the normal intracranial pressure is 5 to 15 mm of mercury. And altered level of consciousness is most earliest and sensitive indication of increased ICP. So the earliest indicator of increased ICP is the altered LOC. And the later signs of increased ICP are, first is increased systolic BP, second is widened pulse pressure, and third is slowed heart rate or bradycardia. So if there is an increased ICP, then what position should be given? Elevate the head of the bed to 30 to 40 degree. And please avoid the Trendelenburg position or prevent the flexion of neck and hip. So next question is from, next pointer is from autonomic dysreflexia. So autonomic dysreflexia occurs with injuries above T6 and in cervical lesions. And the sign and symptoms are very important for your exam. So sign and symptoms of autonomic dysreflexia are sudden severe thrombic headache, severe hypertension and bradycardia, then flushing over the level of injury, then pale extremities below the level of injury, then nasal stuffness, dilated pupils, then blurred vision, sweating, pyloreaction means goosebump, then restlessness and feeling of apprehension. So all these are symptoms seen in case of autonomic dysreflexia. So the next important pointer is about GCS, that is a Glasgow Coma Scale. So we all know it is a neurological scale and this is used to check the patient level of consciousness. So there are total 3 parameters in Glasgow Coma Scale. First is the eye opening response, second is the verbal response, and third one is the motor response. And we have to check the patient response in these 3 parameters, and we have to give the score to the patient accordingly as shown in the chart. So in eye opening response, we have to check whether the patient response is spontaneous or to speech or to pain or there is a no response. So next is a best verbal response. So in this we have to check the patient orientation to time, place and person, whether he is confused, whether there are inappropriate words, incomprehensible sounds or no response at all. And third one is the best motor response. So in this we have to check whether the patient obeys the command, then moves to the localized pain, then there is a flexion, means withdrawal from pain, then abnormal flexion, abnormal extension or no response at all. So after checking against all these 3 parameters, we have to check the total score of a patient. So the maximum score for GCS is the 15 and minimum score is the 3. So score of 3 means patient is totally unresponsive, and score of 15 is a best response. So our next pointers are from sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. So these two are the important divisions of the autonomic nervous system, and usually the questions are asked from this portion. So if I talk about sympathetic nervous system, so this system is responsible for flight and fight actions at time of emergency. And at this time, the dilated pupils are seen, then salivation is inhibited, then heart rate is increased, and there is an increased release of the glucose. And inhibition of normal bodily processes is seen, which are not important at time of emergency, like digestion and urination. While in case of parasympathetic nervous system, it is responsible for rest and digestive actions. So in this, there is a constriction of pupil, then salivation is stimulated, then heart rate is slowed, then airways are constricted, and there is a stimulation of the normal bodily processes like digestion, urination, plus also there is inhibition of release of the glucose. So next is, myasthenia gravis is a neuromuscular disease caused by insufficient secretion of acetylcholine and excessive secretion of cholinesterase. And Parkinson's disease is a degenerative disease caused by depletion of the dopamine. So myasthenia gravis is associated with acetylcholine deficiency, and Parkinson's disease is associated with dopamine deficiency. And next is presbycusis. So presbycusis is a sensory neural hearing loss, and this is related to the aging process. And presbyopia is a gradual loss of eye's ability to focus on nearby objects. So presbycusis and presbyopia is both related to the aging process, and presbycusis is hearing loss and presbyopia is a vision loss. So next is astigmatism. So astigmatism occurs because of irregular curvature of cornea, and in this the image focus on two different points on retina. So next is intraocular pressure. Normal in IOP is a 10 to 21 mm of mercury. And the tonometry is a method to measure the IOP. So next is open angle glaucoma. So it is the most common form of glaucoma. And in this, the drainage angle is formed by cornea and iris remains open, but the trabecular meshwork is partially blocked. And angle closure glaucoma is a less common form of glaucoma, and this is caused by blockage of the drainage canals, and this results in sudden rise in IOP. So most common form of glaucoma is a open angle glaucoma. So our next pointer is, the open angle glaucoma causes painless increase in IOP with the tunnel vision, while angle closure glaucoma causes a severe eye pain. So next is, sign of retinal detachment are flashes of light, sense of curtain falling, painless loss of central or peripheral vision, and flutters or black spots. So next is, Meniere syndrome is characterized by tinnitus, unilateral hearing loss, and vertigo. And low sodium diet is recommended for a patient with Meniere disease. So with this, moving to the next pointers from respiratory system. So asthma is marked by airway inflammation and hyperresponsiveness to variety of stimuli or triggers. So next is, Venturi mask is most accurate method of oxygen delivery for COPD patient. So next pointer is, the most common initial symptom in pulmonary embolism is a chest pain that is sudden in onset. So next pointer is, diagnosis of tuberculosis is confirmed by sputum culture. So next pointer is, the test used for HIV confirmation is Western blot test, then eyeglasses to correct myopia is concave lens, and eyeglasses to correct hypermyopia is convex lens. Then therapeutic serum digoxin level is 0.5 to 2 nanogram per ml, and digoxin should be held if apical pulse is lower than 60 beats per minute. So now let's learn about some antidotes. The antidote for warfarin is vitamin K. Antidote for heparin is protamine sulfate. Antidote for streptokinase is aminocaproic acid. In digoxin toxicity, the antidote is digoxin immune fab or digibind. In acetaminophen toxicity, antidote is N-acetylcysteine. In benzodiazepine toxicity, antidote is flumazenil. In opioid overdose, antidote is नैलोक्सेन, इन ऑर्गेनोफॉस्फेट पॉइजनिंग एंटीडोट इज एट्रोपिन। सो नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंटर इज नॉर्मल सीरम पोटाशियम लेवल इज 3.5 to 5.1 मिलियो इक्विवेलेंट पर लीटर। नेक्स्ट इज वूंड डहिसेंस इज अ सेपरेशन ऑफ वूंड एजेस एट सूचर लाइन एंड दिस यूजली अकर्स 6 to 8 days आफ्टर सर्जरी। वाइल वूंड एविसरेशन इज अ प्रोट्यूजन ऑफ इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स थ्रू इनसीजन एंड दिस यूजली अकर्स 6 to 8 days आफ्टर सर्जरी। सो दिस वूंड एविसरेशन इज अ मेडिकल इमरजेंसी एंड दिस वूंड एविसरेशन कैन बी सीन इन ओबीज क्लाइंट और द पेशेंट हु आर हैविंग अ पुअर वूंड हीलिंग। सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑलरेडी आस्क्ड इन प्रीवियस BFUHS एग्जाम। सो नेक्स्ट इज फॉर एनीमा एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन प्रोवाइड लेफ्ट लेटरल और लेफ्ट सिम्स पोजिशन। सो दिस विल अलाउ द सोल्यूशन टू फ्लो बाई ग्रेविटी इन नेचुरल डायरेक्शन ऑफ द कोलन। सो फॉर एनीमा एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन लेफ्ट लेटरल और सिम्स पोजिशन इज प्रोवाइडेड। सो इन हाइमरोडेक्टमी असिस्ट द क्लाइंट टू लेटरल और साइड लाइन पोजिशन सो डेट टू प्रिवेंट द पेन एंड ब्लीडिंग। एंड इन GERD डेट इज गैस्ट्रोइसोफेजियल रिफ्लक्स डिजीज प्रोवाइड रिवर्स ट्रेंडल वर्क पोजिशन सो डेट टू प्रमोट द गैस्ट्रिक एम्पटिंग एंड प्रिवेंट द रिफ्लक्स डिजीज। सो नेक्स्ट इज पैरासेंथेसिस। सो फॉर पैरासेंथेसिस प्रोवाइड द सेमी फॉलर पोजिशन टू द पेशेंट और प्रोवाइड द सिटिंग अपराइट पोजिशन ऑन साइड ऑफ बेड और चेयर विद फीट सपोर्टेड। सो नेक्स्ट इज फॉर पेशेंट विद एस्ट्रीमिक स्ट्रोक हेड ऑफ द बेड इज यूजली केप्ट फ्लैट। सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंटर इज इन हेमरेजिक स्ट्रोक द हेड ऑफ द बेड इज एलिवेटेड टू 30 degrees so that to reduce the intracranial pressure and also to facilitate the venous drainage. And in autonomic dysreflexia the high Fowler's position is provided so that to prevent the hypertensive stroke. So in the next pointers I will discuss some fever patterns, so you can easily expect one question from these pointers. So let's start with the remittent fever. So remittent fever is characterized by variation of more than 2 degrees between morning and evening but the temperature doesn't reach to the normal. Next is constant or continuous fever. So it is a fever in which the temperature varies not more than 2 degrees between morning and evening but it doesn't reach to the normal. So next is relapsing fever. So in relapsing fever there are the brief periods followed by one or more days of the normal temperature. So this is typically seen in malaria or lymphoma. So next is intermittent fever. So in intermittent fever the temperature rises from normal or subnormal temperature to the high fever and then it comes back at a regular intervals and usually the temperature is higher in the evening than the morning. So next is inverse fever. So in this type the highest range of temperature is recorded in a morning and lowest in a evening. So next is a rigor. So rigor is a sudden severe attack of shivering in which the body temperature rises rapidly to stage of hyperpyrexia. So next is lysis. So lysis is a one in which the temperature falls in a zigzag manner for 1 to 2 days or for a week before reaching the normal. So next is pyrocrisis. So in this the temperature falls suddenly within hours and touches the normal and this is accompanied by improvement in a patient condition. And in false crisis the temperature falls suddenly but this doesn't accompanied by the improvement in patient condition. So now let's learn about some cation and anions. So the most abundant cation in extracellular fluid is the sodium. Most abundant anion in extracellular fluid is the chloride, while most abundant cation in intracellular fluid is the potassium and most abundant anion in intracellular fluid is the phosphate. So next pointer is a positive Hohmann signs indicate the thrombophlebitis. Next is RL ringer lactate shouldn't be used for treatment of lactic acidosis or severe metabolic acidosis. So next pointer is the subclavian and jugular veins are used for TPN, total parenteral nutrition. So next pointer is the sharp instruments should not be sterilized by boiling water. So this can lead to the blunting of instruments. सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंटर इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द कॉजेज ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक एसिडोसिस आर डायबिटीज मिलाइटस, रीनल फेलियर, माल न्यूट्रिशन, सीवियर डायरिया एंड हाई फैट डाइट. सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंटर इज द एक्सेसिव वॉमिटिंग, जी आई सक्शनिंग, मैसिव ट्रांसफ्यूजन ऑफ होल ब्लड, दिस कैन लेड टू द मेटाबॉलिक एल्केलोसिस. सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंटर इज द ब्रेडन स्केल इज यूज फॉर प्रोडिक्टिंग द रिस्क ऑफ द प्रेशर अल्सर्स. सो आर लास्ट पॉइंटर्स आर अबाउट थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ मॉर्टिस. सो फर्स्ट इज द राइगर मॉर्टिस. सो इट इज़ अ स्टिफनेस और रिजिडिटी ऑफ बॉडी आफ्टर डेथ. देन एल्गर मॉर्टिस, इट इज़ अ कूलिंग ऑफ बॉडी आफ्टर डेथ. एंड देन थर्ड इज अ लिवर मॉर्टिस, इट इज़ अ लास्ट पॉइंट ऑफ टूडेज वीडियो. सो लिवर मॉर्टिस रेफर्स टू ब्लूइश पर्पल डिस्कलरेशन अंडर स्किन ऑफ अ लोअर बॉडी पार्ट्स एंड दिस इज ड्यू टू द ग्रेविटेशन ऑफ ब्लड आफ्टर डेथ. All right, friends. So that's all about the today's video. And if you really like the video, then please press the like button and share with your friends who are going to appear for Baba Fareed University of Health Sciences exam, staff nurses exam. So we'll see you in my next video very soon. Till that time, stay tuned, stay safe. Thank you.